Ladies and gentlemen, Bob O'Brien of WWOR-TV, UPN 9, the president of the Inner Circle.
Thank you. I want to welcome you all to the 80th Inner Circle Show. We are proud to be preceded by 79 years of political, satirical, musical comedy. That's what we do. But there's never been a year in which a single event challenged everyday life for all of us like the attack on America has. September 11th, the victims, the heroes, the survivors, and to varying degrees, we are all survivors, are not mentioned directly in our show tonight. There is no comedy in that tragedy. However, the spirit that the attack has sparked among us as New Yorkers and as Americans will be reflected in our show tonight. So I invite you all now to stand for a moment of silence, remembering those that we lost, and then after that, please join us as we sing our national anthem. Thank you very much. And now, the Inner Circle's first crack at the Bloomberg administration. Thanks a Billion is the name of our show. First of all, though, I would like to thank Con Edison for being the gracious host of our pre-show reception. Hand for their party really set us up for a great night of fun at the expense of numerous people in the audience here. Usually, you know, it's Inner Circle and then it's spring. But this year, spring preceded the Inner Circle. We're just about a month later than usual, but we really needed the time. Because unlike his predecessor, Mayor Mike Bloomberg didn't come to us as a public figure with a penchant for overexposure, politically, that is. And since he's been in City Hall, at least on weekdays, for over 3 months now, the former private mogul has revealed something of his style as the big towns knew his honor. He rides the subway, handing out cards that say, Michael Bloomberg, Mayor, New York City. That's so his fellow travelers know who the strap hanger with all the well-dressed cops around him is. Now, we also learned this week that Mayor Bloomberg is ambidextrous. We should have known earlier. He could have been writing checks with both hands. He took the mound at Shea Stadium opener as a right-hander. His ceremonial first pitch was a strike. But what's he done so far as mayor? He abolished the Decency Commission, giving us considerable latitude in our script writing and still allowing our show to go on. And there is certainly a different feeling in town now that Rudy's gone private and Mayor Mike is in charge. Like Rudy chased the Grammys away. Mayor Mike is wooing them back from LA, promising to buy up each and every remaining CD of Mariah Carey's Glitter and incinerate them. We don't want to say that the mayor's been away from town a lot, but his passport visa stamps are now on volume 47. We are very glad the mayor's doing the Inner Circle show. At least we know he's in the city this weekend. I saw the mayor at a recent news event and wished him the traditional break a leg for his Inner Circle performance, and he said, "What performance? All I have to do is get up there and prove I have better legs than Giuliani." Will we see? Are his legs shaved too? We'll all see later. And a dinner note. Since this is the night that clocks spring forward, we have changed the dinner menu from steaks and salmon to a selection of your favorite dry cereals. Anyway, people have been saying for years that it's a challenge watching our show on a full stomach. So, you know, that'll help. And in the spirit of having as many of you leave with emptier pockets for a good cause, there is a silent auction in the ballroom lobby. The original artwork of Randy and Suzanne Jones, which graces our program, will be auctioned off. You write your bids at the lobby table. And for the first time ever, some of costume designer Catherine Piper's most creative get-ups will be part of the silent auction. When you see the show, just remember, you too can go home as Cashman or in the Riddler's green suit made of satin. There's also handmade silk burkas and sequined American flag t-shirts to go with them. Some baseball enthusiast is definitely going to snatch up the vintage Brooklyn Dodgers uniform, hand tea-stained for the antique look. And finally, an Inner Circle exclusive. We are proud to present the world premiere of the first I Love New York commercials filmed under our new mayor, Michael Bloomberg. I direct your attention to the screens above.
Since Giuliani left, I love New York.
Good evening, and thanks for being one of the dozens of people listening to Bloomberg Radio. We're live outside City Hall, where protesters are making their voices heard on the state of the New York City economy. With us, three top financial titans. Gentlemen, the protesters are revolting. Tell me why.
We've got a $4.8 billion budget gap. It's Dinkins deja vu.
On Wall Street, the Dow Jones numbers are lower than Channel 2's ratings, even with Penny Crone.
At least with Mike Bloomberg in charge, this city has a man who can eliminate the deficit with one swipe of his ATM card and have enough left over for a peanut butter and banana sandwich. Come on, Mayor Mike. Whip out that wallet and save the city.
Mayor Mike.
Yes, I could save the city with my own money, but where's the fun in that? Besides, if I spent all my own money now, how would I get reelected? Oh, no one ever heard of me until I spent all my money.
Ain't it strange?
A Bloomberg box can set you free, but it's no match for Fox TV.
It's small change. In his dreams, he had a plan. Why not vote for a wealthy man? The mayor's boy. would buy the fame his radios could not attain. Money, 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 spent a tonny, now he's Mayor Mike. Money, 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 yes he won, so what's not to like? Subway, he's pretending to be average in a rich man's world. In a rich man's world.
On Groundhog Day, he hugs a truck, the firemen, they run amok.
Ain't it strange?
He jokes about the budget cuts, to him it won't amount to much.
It's small change. He's worth $4 billion, a lot of dough. Hired lots of politicos, and if a problem proves too hard, he'll fix it with his credit card. Money, 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 spent a tonny, now he's Mayor Mike. Money, 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 yes he won, so what's not to like? Watch him hail in a cab, he's pretending to be average in a rich man's world. Money, 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 makes life funny in a rich man's world. Money, 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 always sunny in a rich man's world. Scoffing burgers and fries, he's pretending to be average in a rich man's world. In a rich man's world.
As your police commissioner, Mayor Mike, I'm afraid I got to tell you that your budget cuts are having effect already. Look, just across the street from City Hall, they're sticking up Starbucks.
Which one?
And it's getting worse. Henry Stern just shredded 100 trees.
He told me he'd do anything to get that job at Arthur Anderson. Commissioner Kelly, if I knew the job was going to be this tough, I would have only spent $97 million. Who left us this mess?
Didst thou callest my name?
Sir Rudy, man, that knighthood has really gone to your head.
I'm New York's greatest mayor. Bigger than Beam. Hornier than Jimmy Walker.
He's a tricky one. During his last week in office, he gave the Mets and the Yankees a pass, turned the Staten Island home port into the Danny Aiello home for underutilized actors. Then he stole the city records for the Giuliani Library.
And I didn't even get a library card.
I left you something, a $4.8 billion budget gap, and a pair of fishnet stockings in the right-hand drawer of your desk.
Too big.
The gap or the stockings?
Old Mike Bloomberg has his billions. Just name one thing he ain't bought. But the city is in the red, babe. $500 million
more than we thought. Michael Bloomberg has a big jet, lots of houses, he's doing fine. But I left him with a mess, babe. So he's got to toe the line. Now the schools, hey, they are a terrible mess. Board of Education is the oohs and lies. They need someone to take over. Could that someone be Mike the Knife? Oh, the garbage jet, he wants to burn it, don't you know? Yeah, from Wakefield down to Sheepshead Bay. But the swells on the Upper East Side, just a speck of foot, and he thinks they'll run away. Now, did you hear about Gifford Miller? He's the boy speaker, don't you know? Up against the mayor in a budget war. Now there's no money for the council. Mike the Knife used Gift to mop the floor. Now Big Bill Thompson, yeah, Betsy got bound. Well, the Reverend Al too, man, he's such a clown. They're all moving to the right, babe, now that Mike, he runs the town. And then there's Charlie Rangel and Sheldon Silver, don't you know? Well, we've got Tacky as well, all of great renown. They're all moving to the right, babe, now that Bloomberg runs the town. Look out, I'm coming back.
The only way you're going to top that act, Mayor Mike, is by opening your wallet.
I will not spend a dime of my own money. We're all cutting back. Except at the Brooklyn District Attorney's Office. Who's running that show? Sherlock Hines?
Sure, my staff is growing. But they're all great top-notch hires. Like my latest discovery, crime scene investigator Howie Golden.
Hello, you humps.
Tell me again, Howie, why did I hire you?
Because you needed fresh blood.
Right. I assigned you to investigate Borough President Marty Markowitz. I suspect a whitewash. Since he took office, the portraits of our revered old white men, George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, Pete Hamill, have all disappeared from Borough Hall.
Case closed. I found them all at Junior's having a pastrami on Wonder Bread with mayo.
How in the course of human events did the people of Brooklyn ever elect Marty Markowitz?
Nothing you can say, we just came this way. We're white guys.
White guys.
Go to Borough Hall, we're not there at all. We're white guys.
White guys.
We just got stuck with pale complexions, but we don't get Michael Jackson, the fathers of our land. Our skin is way too bland, we're white guys.
I brought wrote the Declaration, I think that's tops. Even while his slaves were tending the crops.
In the Revolution we beat the Brits.
Who's this guy Marty Markowitz? No history book can change our look. We're white guys.
White guys.
No gilded frame that bears our name. We're white guys. No longer U.S. superstars, but Johnny Cochran, Al Sharpton. They are. There's not a Paul today who won't take us away. We're white guys.
Lighten up.
There's not a Paul today who could see it our way. We're white guys.
Tell me more.
There's not a Paul today who could see it our way. We're white guys.
Tonight on Bloomberg Radio, Meet the Mayor. What? I'm sorry. I've just learned that the mayor is on WCBS, making jokes about firing workers. So let's do Meet the Labor Leaders. Dennis Rivera. Que pasa?
I've just come back from organizing the squeegee workers. We're going to sue the city for $100 million in disability.
On what grounds?
They got carpal tunnel. At the Holland Tunnel. It was from reaching up to all those SUVs.
Patrick Lynch of the PBA. I'm getting a late-breaking report that thousands of unemployed are storming City Hall. Gracie Mansion, in fact. Do we have enough cops to handle the crisis at Gracie Mansion?
Who cares? Bloomberg doesn't live there.
That's right.
But someone ought to let Donna Hanover know.
It's getting worse. The unemployed thinks Bloomberg has enough money to hire them all.
Well, how else do you think you carry son got a job?
Andrew Giuliani didn't want it?
Hey, look, Commissioner Kelly's here. And isn't that Broadway Joe Namath, the mayor's role model for swinging bachelors? But where's the mayor?
A gentleman never tells. Sorry, the mayor doesn't do weekends in New York. Who knows where he is?
Only 4 or 5 hours from Broadway. That's where our mayor is found. Mayor Rudy, that droid you could never avoid. But this guy is never around. London, Bermuda, the Rockies. Jetting to some far offshore. You'd think he would care, our fair billionaire. Who knew we elected Mark Shaw?
Don't worry. The mayor may be away, but he's authorized me to call on the one person who can solve any crisis. This is a job for Cash Man.
Cash Man! Cash Man! Cash Man! Cash Man! Cash Man! Cash Man! Cash Man!
I'm Cash Man. The buck starts here. And this is Patty, Penny, my girl Wonder.
Why do you need a sidekick?
He's too embarrassed to buy his own tights.
You know, enough. We're here to solve problems, not to chit-chat about my male psyche. Lynch, take this money to the rioting masses. Tell them it came from a friend of Mayor Mike.
Cashman.
I have got $4 billion.
He has got $4 billion.
I can write a lot of checks.
He can write a lot of checks.
I have got $4 billion.
All right, already we know.
I'm really, really rich.
He's really, really rich.
If you don't have $4 billion, life's a bitch.
Come on, baby.
Cash Man, why is he getting all the credit? Why not me, Betsy Catbaum? The second greatest public advocate ever. I'll tell you why. Nobody knows what I do. I need a purpose. I can always bring back cats, but everybody's seen it. And besides, I'm broke. The mayor cut my budget 20%, and all I have left is my loyal secretary, Kitty Litter. I need some scratch.
Riddle me this, Catbaum. Is there a man in New York who can get elected controller after failing to pay his taxes?
William Thompson, the biggest puzzle of last year's election.
Riddle me this. How can a relatively obscure politician like me distinguish himself following the massive footsteps of Alan Hevesy?
You've got to be kidding. No one knew Hevesy was here when he was here.
I can do that. In fact, if I keep agreeing with everything Mayor Bloomberg says, I can create a new identity for myself. The Invisible Man.
Listen, Betsy, can you tell me why that nobody knows I'm the guy who watched the dough, baby?
Bloomberg never calls me. I'm only getting dissed, and I really am pissed.
Won't call you baby.
My claim to fame, pointy ears, and I'm furry. We all better worry, 'cause baby, there ain't no way we know enough. How do we do all the stuff? We can schmooze and we can bluff to be on the evening news, babe.
Remember the day the IRS reminded me I didn't pay my tax, darling. From that day on, I made a vow I keep track of the money, but who knows how?
'Cause baby, there ain't no way we know enough. How do we do all the stuff? We can snooze and we can bluff to be on the evening news, babe.
No, no, darling.
Want fame today, but if I fall, help's on the way.
Now, baby.
Give Victor a call.
You'll be there on the double with TV screen.
Oh, baby. No one knows I'm alive, but I'll never quit. I am public advocate.
If ambition calls, and if I dare, daddy's there on the double, swearing me in as mayor.
Don't you know that there ain't no way we know enough? How do we do all the stuff? We can screw the weak and bluff to be on the news. Ain't no way we know enough. How do we do all the stuff? We can screw the weak and bluff to be on the news. Ain't no way we know enough.
This is the Lexington Avenue line. Next stop, the stately manor of Mayor Bloomberg.
As if the subway isn't crowded enough, Mayor Mike has to ride it to work every morning. Now, what's up with that?
Thanks.
He digs Peruvian pan flute music.
No, he likes to try out his new policies on the subway before he gets to City Hall. Look, he's about to unleash his new economic plan.
Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it.
Excuse me! I don't live in Gracie Mansion. I don't do drugs. But I do have a problem. My city needs $4.8 billion. I don't want to lay off city employees. I don't want to raise your taxes. If you can give any amount, a penny, a quarter, $8 million, that would really help. Thank you. I know riding the subway is good for my image, but this is killing me. You know where I'd rather be? Off I go into the wild blue yonder private jet at my command. Flying high, weekending in Bermuda. Anytime I need a tan, I have got a Napoleonic complex. Sell me short, I'll drop a bomb. The board of Ed, I left for dead. Nothing can stop the Bloomberg Air Force.
Okay, good. Go ahead, Dan.
Hey, flyboy, you're not going anywhere until you speak with us. You're dealing with the new city council now.
Term limits forced us to get rid of the old hacks. But we've replaced them with new hacks.
That's why, under Speaker Gifford Miller, we're still doing what we do best, naming streets. And parks and buildings, too.
I thought Donald Trump did that. Whatever. So many of us are new on the city council. We can only dream of accomplishing something meaningful in office.
Fairy tales may come true with a council that's new, if not young or smart. It's not clear why we're here, but we're getting in gear, making a fresh start. Give us all enough rope, just to ruin a dose. Can we cope? It's our hope, but don't count on it, no. Nothing will get done, but we'll all have fun. Learning how to fake abiding states. Men's Park.
Come on. Let's go. Ralph Penza should be coming out with one of our most esteemed Inner Circle members, if he can find her. Penza, can we find you? Here he is. He's taking on a new form, that of Paul Ehrlich. Go out, Paul.
Here I am.
Go.
You know, another exciting part about working in this council, you get to meet the nation's top law enforcement officials.
That's right, Councilman Rodriguez. And by the way, you're under arrest.
Oh.
You're under arrest. Enter Cashman.
You. Out.
This guy. Quick, Penny, they're just about to sell the naming rights for the city council itself to Yahoo.com.
Wouldn't that make them sound stupid?
In two words, impossible. Give them the check. Tell them it came from a friend of Mayor Mike.
Next stop, City Hall, home of the 2012 Olympics. No need to go all the way to France to bribe a judge.
Thank you very much. I'm Dr. Doktorov, deputy mayor in charge of luring the Olympics here to New York City for the year 2012. With me, just think of the benefits. More traffic, more illegal aliens, and something to take our mind off those Knicks.
All the deputy mayors are pitching in. Imagine what New York can offer. Extreme parking, hailing a cab while black, synchronized shoplifting.
No, I'm sorry. Winona Ryder already took home the gold in that last event. She didn't win. She just took home the gold.
Tonight, the Russian and Canadian gold medal skaters will take on Helen Marshall of Queens in the 80-yard dash to see who can cross Queens Boulevard without getting flattened by a Federal Express truck.
The Canadians are taking an early lead, but oh, a Con Ed truck just put their lights out. The Russians are gaining, but oh, they can't seem to make their way around an articulated bus. That leaves Mrs. Marshall. She's made it to the eastbound lanes. She's made it to the traffic island. She's crossing the westbound lanes. And it looks like, yes, we have a winner.
I cross Queens Boulevard. I want you to know it was very, very hard. Some say I'm not that strong, but nothing can keep me from my mahjong.
Okay, Pastor Good. Hello. I guess I'm back.
Wow, finally the real reason New York City deserves the Olympics in 2012. Actually, it's my own amazing ability at the luge. And let's go to the videotape.
Would anyone like to come inside and see the new bullpen we've created for Mayor Bloomberg upstairs at City Hall? It's the latest in modern office design. Perhaps you've seen the blueprint. Look above.
Keep looking.
Come on, Larry.
Now, look, when I, Mark Shaw, run this place on weekends, I want to be in a position of power. Why isn't the mayor downstairs in the mayor's office?
Apparently, Rudy Giuliani was successful in getting that term extension.
And don't forget Mayor Bloomberg's greatest accomplishment. He installed fish tanks at City Hall. He says they're soothing.
Absolutely. Actually, we've got big tanks. And we've got little tanks. And the little tanks are where we store the microfiche.
When Republicans leave City Hall and Giuliani leaves
the sharks will know it's feeding time. And barracudas start to rage. This is the dawning of the age of aquarium. Goodbye to old pond scum. Aquarium. Aquarium. Never making any headlines. Mike don't care about their deadlines. Wants control of education. Won't say when he's on vacation. Working weekends makes him crabby. Life for Bloomberg ain't so shabby. Aquarium. We're so humdrum.
When the prize for getting good PR
is a bonus check from Bloomberg's bank,
and meetings over caviar,
you know we've jumped into the mayor's tank. This is the dawning of the age of aquarium. Go take a Valium.
It's so
well, you know, you did a good job, Deputy Mayors. Unfortunately, there's no money in the budget to reward you. That's why the mayor hired his daughter and his sister for nothing. But, of course, I do have a spot bonus from a friend of Mayor Mike.
Aunt Marjorie, I don't know why Dad bothers to pay those guys when he's got so many perfectly good relatives willing to work for free.
So true, Emma. Besides, politics has a rich history of helpful relatives. Billy Carter, Roger Clinton, and Clarence Norman III. I hear his dad is trying to sell the Brooklyn Bridge.
That's the only thing in Brooklyn that hasn't been sold.
Hey, Emma, all these guys are making a bundle. When is our payday?
We don't have one.
Studied really hard, graduated Princeton, thought I had all kinds of ambition, but doctor, lawyer, I'm just not the type.
Got really bored, stuck in my manor, social work sucked and I needed some glamour,
so we sent our resumes to Mayor Mike. Working for no cash, so much for nepotism, not one thin red dime. We're not taking, we're just giving, we do all the work. Gives us credit, we would quit, except he's got us both indebted. I skipped the rungs on the city ladder, tabloid press got madder and madder. Daddy says they're pissed because they're poor.
At the UN, they think I'm really able. I meet diplomats and I get to wear sable.
If you don't like us, you're getting what you pay for. Working for no cash, you get something for nothing. Rudy got a pass when he hired all his cousins. We are qualified just to calm your fears. We've been putting up with Mike's ego all these years. Working for no cash.
Can you believe a man as rich as Bloomberg would allow his daughter and his sister to work for nothing? And now he's got you, his own mother, in a job training program in the Bronx. Tell me, what are they teaching you there?
They're teaching me how to work at McDonald's. Would you like me to supersize those fries?
All right.
Great job, Edie.
Good job.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Inner Circle show will now take a break so that we may bring you a special edition of New York One's top political segment, The Wise Guys.
I'm Al D'Amato. I used to be your senator.
I'm Ed Koch. I used to be your mayor.
I'm Mark Green. I used to be your next mayor.
Mark, your campaign was so bad that even your wife voted for Bloomberg.
The truth? So did I.
Easy, Ed. You know this wasn't Mark's only TV offer.
I understand that Mark wanted to be on Friends. But he didn't have any.
I'm such a schmuck. Painfully clear. Better than Rudy, I said. So I'm still here. Being a schmuck. All my career aiming at this, no chance to lose, but the race was close as a kiss. I managed to miss political bliss. Now every night on the TV I run my mouth about Bloomberg, but wish I were he. Tossing off quips,
bada bing,
with my permatan smile. Even my wife switches the dial. Can we afford to take a chance? Posing that question was dumber than dropping my pants. Just like a schmuck, I'm such a schmuck. Ah, forget it. Let's dance.
You know, I'd give him some money, but as a friend of Mayor Mike, I should really reward the men who made Mark Green what he is today out of office.
Do I hear a conga? Could it be Mayor Bloomberg's Latino coalition, led by Freddie Ferrer and Adolfo Carrion?
Gentlemen, here's your checks. They came from a friend of Mayor Mike. Hey.
Gracias, mi amigo. Backing Bloomberg was the best thing we ever did for the Latinos, Freddie Ferrer. Besides, I think he's one of us. Isn't Bermuda right next door to the Dominican Republic?
Carry on, my wayward son. You don't actually have to be a Latino to join the Latino coalition. Why, don't you remember why Roberto Ramirez, Jose Rivera, and myself all welcomed Al Sharpton into the fold?
Pesos. Or was it his 30-year collection of Santana records?
Latino weasels treated Mark Green like he had measles. We stayed away election night. He lost the fight, 'cause we played it cool.
Don't call us loco. Our backing Bloomberg was in poco. And the old Latin quid pro quo. It sure applies here.
So don't forget who put you on the throne. We can't live our lives on thanks alone. Better make a smile or in 2005 you won't survive.
You better treat us real good and don't have a cow.
Well, it's our treason that's the reason you're the mayor now.
You've got the kind of power that can do us good, so give us our props.
If you don't, we won't forget about it. We won't forget about it. We won't forget about it.
Those guys don't get it, Randy Weingarten. Mayor Mike isn't about money. He just wants results.
So, Chancellor Levy, is that why you were so quick to allow the corporate sponsorship of the Bronx High School of Science?
Hey, there's nothing wrong with the Ballpark Franks School of Science. It plumps when you cook it.
That's still not good enough. The mayor wants cuts.
Oh, he'll get them. We're remodeling the entire school system to mirror the famous Bloomberg bullpen. All 1 million students will be in one big classroom in the Tweed Courthouse with a single teacher in the middle.
The teachers' union won't stand for that. We're suing.
Hey, that one teacher will be paid $1 million. The UFT will become the OFT. One federated teacher.
Where do I sign? Like the mayor says, we've all got to share the pain.
Shooby dooby 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 doo wappa. Shooby dooby 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 doo wappa.
Share the pain. Bloomberg tells me. But will he share his billions? No, sirree. Share the pain. Looks like the rich man has a plan.
The schools and shelters are all a mess. He slashed their budgets after lunch at Lutez. Share the pain. Looks like the rich man has a plan.
Shooby dooby 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 doo bop bop. Shooby dooby doo ba.
Gotta borrow to pay the bills that Giuliani left us all. Won't allow it to cramp his style. He'll just cut 20% and have a ball.
Share the pain. Let teachers go. Pay more for parking tickets than a Broadway show. Share the pain. Looks like the rich man has a plan.
Shooby dooby 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 doo bop bop. Shooby dooby 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 doo bop bop.
Share the pain.
Look.
looks like the rich man has a plan.
Share the pain.
Looks like the rich man has a plan.
Share the pain.
Looks like the rich man has a plan.
Penny. I don't know how to tell you this. I've been writing so many checks. I'm flat broke. Worse yet, I think that chick hanging with Sir Rudy has discovered my secret identity.
Big deal. She doesn't say much anyway.
Hey, Cashman, or should I say, Mayor Bloomberg.
I've been outed, just like Rosie O'Donnell.
You can't fool me. I know that you've been trying to save the city with your own money, but I also know that you are broke. But I've been sent here by my very special friend to help.
Now, why would Sir Rudy do that?
Because he's my knight in shining armor.
Then years later made a dame of me. What a mayor, what a knight. Night and dame, we are like one. I never leave his side, my grin bright as the sun. I am his, he's 7 cent. Can't wait till he's president. Night and dame, dame and night. He sometimes acts like a dame. You know it's all just a game. He isn't too bad at night. That's 'cause I turn out the light. There is nothing left to do but guess. If neath that armor he wears a dress, a sequined frilly fancy décolleté. Now I shout it from the city hall. Has no hair, but he at least is tall. And now the world doth him adore. Secret loves no secret anymore. Night.
You see, during his last known week in office, my Rudy was on a secret mission. He went to England, where he sold New York City back to the Queen.
So that's how he got the knighthood.
And that means the Queen of England is responsible for all those bills. You're off the hook, Cashman. Or should I say, Mayor Mike?
Doesn't matter that I'm not wearing armor, can't you tell I'm a superstar? A Giuliani, maybe some people's hero, but the cross-dressing dude's bizarre. Don't care if he tries to sell back the nation, as long as I can keep my radio station. No debt, no sweat, I'm still in the jet set. I own City Hall, that's me. Oh, it doesn't matter what they say in the papers, 'cause they always tell the same old lies. I put on tights and cape just to make my escape. It's my politician disguise from media snoots and spies. Just because I got a place in Bermuda and my own ski resort in Vail, just because I am straight, rich, and single, and a very hot, desirable male, Don't wanna see my reputation attacked. Don't wanna watch reporters overreact. I'm a smash man, cash man. Don't file no fight plan. I own City Hall, that's me. There's no bigger player than the Big Apple's mayor, cause I own City Hall, that's me.
We're out of here.
So now the secret is out. Underneath this mild-mannered, milquetoast personality, there beats the heart of a superhero. We're off the hook.
We're free and clear.
It's all here in the city records Sir Rudy stole for the Giuliani Library. He's giving them back to us out of the kindness of his heart and a court order.
All right, New York, we're back. Everybody on the plane, we're going to Bermuda.
Going broke and Rudy was departing. Tough to follow in his shoes, it wouldn't be no bargain. Gotta find a chump who could run this dump. A simple schmuck who made a muck and wasn't Donald Trump. And now it's springtime for Bloomberg. Making the best of a mess. We're floating in these river tones, trying to fill our fortune holes.
Springtime for Bloomberg and NYC.
Look, it's springtime.
Sega, Reds, and screws up, bet Rudy comes back.
5, 6, 7, 8. Bought his job, but that's no crime. Slips away from time to time.
He's no dummy, he's a smarty. Now he owns the grand old party.
Yes, big shoes to step in. If voodoo should happen,
there'll be doo-doo to happen.
The
Enough.
With our 401ks
together,
are dwindling away
together.
Think Enron will pay
together.
Are you nuts? No way
together.
Up in Albany
together.
Pataki wants three
together.
Then he'll be VP
together.
Bush, Gump, Cheney,
go west.
Duck and Hillary,
go west.
Seek publicity,
go west.
But they're getting screwed,
go west.
By George W.
go west.
Texas is the place,
go west.
Where this act takes place,
go west.
Grab your partner and sing.
Over.
Listen up, everyone. There's a new sheriff in town.
My name is Sheriff George W., and I'm here to clean up the evil exes.
You mean like Patricia Duff and Ivana Trump?
Thank you, Condoleezza. What I meant to say was, read my lips. No new axis. Now, where's my trusted deputy, Deadeye Dick Cheney?
He's at an undisclosed location, Albany.
Not anymore. I had to make sure absolutely no one would see me. So I'm sitting at the Newsday table.
Sheriff, if you're going to fight the evil axis, you'll need a posse.
Well, fine. How much do we charge to let them in?
It's a posse, sir, not the Republican Party.
All right. Now, any volunteers for this dangerous mission from which you may never return?
Send Cheney.
Governor Pataki, wait your turn.
We've got the volunteers, Rumsfeld, Ashcroft, and maybe we should find Pap Buchanan. He's always fun at a hanging.
I'm the nation's chief attorney. When you go on a journey, look out when you depart. 'Cause if you wear a turban, all your rights I'll be disturbing, 'cause I haven't got a heart.
Oh, defense is my department. Got guns in my apartment. I'm just a bit insane. We should nuke North Korea, leave them flat as a tortilla, 'cause I wouldn't use my brain.
And me, I'm the VP. My name is Dick Cheney.
He's a guy you're gonna very seldom see.
Keeping us free, invisibly. I already worked for Nixon, but no, I couldn't fix him. And Ford, I don't deserve. I helped Enron get some contracts just by using all my contacts. Boy, I've really got some nerve.
So by now you're all suspecting
we're really not protecting the country that we serve.
I should show some compassion.
I could be a bit impassioned.
I could take a little action.
So the country gets the safety we deserve. If I only use my heart,
my brain,
my nerve.
Oh, we're off to see the White House, the wonderful place that we love. It really is a wonderful place that fits us all like a glove.
Whenever the West Wing is on TV,
I think it's me
or me.
The power trip is fun, we all agree. It gives all of us a lot of glee. We're off to see the White House, the place that we all love to be.
I don't know why the sheriff is sending in men to do a woman's job. Diplomacy takes grace and style. And with my education, I, Condoleezza Rice, am the perfect person to bring about world peace. And if the situation should prove too hot, I'll bring in my good friend, Martha Stewart.
When negotiating in warm, dry climates, I like to dip my shoulder pads in an ice-cold bucket of Gatorade before slipping them under my blouse. Later, they make great coasters.
And what else can you cook up?
I recently had a wonderful opportunity to stencil some sparrow eggshells using the sparrow's nest as the basic ingredient in a warm winter stew.
Oh, okay, this town ain't big enough for the both of us, girl. Take a hike. Huh. I can handle this just fine on my own. I've got the clout, and if the boys get rough, I can be twice as tough. No time to pout. I want the world to know the power I bestow. Surrounded by the guys, I can run the nations with no hesitations. I love foreign relations. Each time I look around, I see Bush and Cheney. I am twice as brainy. Oh, I run the show. The time has come to prove that I'm the one who cares. You need to know I want foreign affairs. I've got the clout, so Saddam, step aside. Osama, you can't hide. I've got the clout, and I won't be content until I'm president. I've got the clout.
You know, that gal ought to do just fine, but who's she gonna talk to?
We've got a lot of allies over there, sir. Pakistan, Uzbekistan, and Taxistan.
Taxis?
If it ever rains, no one will be able to find them.
Well, we got any undercover operatives?
Sure do. They're hidden from head to toe. We call them our burqa babies. Congresswoman Maloney is training them.
We've learned a lot about the enemy. They hate women. They don't believe in contraception. And they all get home delivery of the National Enquirer.
Tell me, do the men wear burqas?
And only in the village.
Ba-boom, 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 ba-boom.
Berkababies, we're undercover femme fatales. Wait and see. This is just a disguise. Berkababies, we're gonna form a posse tonight. Berkababies, the Taliban was giving us gas. Oh no. Now we're kicking their ass. They are crazy. Oh, Bush is gonna give them a fight. Shrouded round in mystery, but you cannot get the things you cannot see. Shred this armor and we're free. We'll take it off for democracy.
Ba-boom, ba-boom.
Pretty ladies, Bin Laden ain't seen nothing like this. Too bad. Now America's mad, ain't no maybe. He's gonna get a whooping tonight. And then we're gonna party tonight. Party tonight.
Move it.
Wow, they're intense.
Of course they're intense. They live in the desert.
Andrew Cuomo. I'd expect a remark like that from a smart aleck kid. Why don't you grow up?
And look like you, Carl McCall? I've seen younger faces on dollar bills.
Enough with the bickering. Neither of us will be governor if we keep this up. So let's run on our records. Mine as a proven state official with plenty of experience. Yours as the Kennedy family boy toy.
Let's forget about the records. We're out west, so I challenge you to a duel. In song.
L is for the way I loathe your style. O, you're older than the River Nile. S, that phony smile you flash once in a while.
E, then in Coxsackie, you'll get murdered by Pataki.
Lose is all that you were born to do.
Lose, it's what the future holds for you.
After this primary,
your career is secondary.
Lose, it's what we're gonna do.
I guess it's true for me and you.
Come on.
Is there a doctor in the house?
There's me, Doc Pataki.
Where did you get your medical license?
Local 1199. And the tuition only cost $2 billion. But I didn't pay, you did.
Doc, you gotta see if there's something you can do for Kid Cuomo and Butch McCaw.
I pronounced you both politically dead.
I want a second opinion.
You should cut down on fatty foods, too. Look, gentlemen, no use arguing. I'm a lock, and that comes straight from my new nominee for Lieutenant Governor, Miss Cleo.
Oh, Mansa, you called me. Man, listen to me. I see you surrounded by a lot of people standing in the snow.
The New Hampshire primary?
No. Buffalo, last January. I also see you, man. I see you hiring a lot of Democrats, raising the unemployment benefits. And listen up, I also see you, man, partying with P. Diddy. This move to the left, even I, Miss Cleo, cannot figure. Please explain, man.
I'm a God-fearing Republican, but sometimes I've got to put aside what I believe. Doesn't mean that I like unions, but I sure know how to count. So I make nice to Rivera and neutralize the UFT. It frustrates McCall and Cuomo, 'cause there's no way they're catching me. Ch-ch-ch-changes.
Time to change the stripes.
Ch-ch-changes.
Third term is looking good.
Ch-ch-changes.
Leaning to the left.
Ch-ch-changes.
Just calling Robin Hood.
I may change me if I want to win. I say that time will change me if I want to win.
You know, the governor's makeover isn't such a bad idea. I've got one scheduled for me right now. Hold on a minute. I'll be right back.
Slow down. Do I look any different? I just had a little work done around my eyes. Hello, I'm Greta Van Susteren. And I'm here to tell you that my news reports will be as tight as the skin tied behind my ears. Who am I anyway, despite my resume? This is a picture of a person I don't know. My face behind my ears, I'll work 1,000 years. Dan, Tom, and Peter had their faces lifted too. And Barbara Walters, she's had 82. Paid my dues in the law, but I've now reconfigured my jaw, and I de-bag my eyes for fame. It's the game. Tell Cokie and Sam and Ted Koppel they don't give a damn. For credentials, you just get blamed. My face is paralyzed with potions. So what if I can't show emotion? Need more lotion? The boss says our pains, but we can't liposuction their brains. Graceful aging we must avoid. They want robotic humanoid. I hope none of this worries you serious news types. At the networks, we still believe that the reporting of current events is a sacred trust. Of course, we are making a few changes to attract the younger demographic.
From ABC News, this is Nightline.
Welcome to Lightline with Ted Koppel and my new co-host, Britney Spears. Tonight, we're examining the war in Afghanistan.
Ooh, and we're gonna find out which global leaders are really, really, really hot.
Very cogent. By the way, Brittany, on this show, we dress in business attire.
Excuse me. This is my business attire.
Let's move on. What about the Social Security crisis?
Oh, Mr. Koppel, I know my Social Security went really down when I broke up with Justin. But now I am looking for someone who's really, really, really hot. Like you, maybe?
Brittany, I know we're trying for a younger, hipper audience, but this is the news.
Oops, sir. I think I did it again. Maybe Mr. Letterman would enjoy my work. When TV ratings are down, what Michael Eisner has found, we need a new kind of sound. It's time to shout it out. Ba 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 ba. Ba 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 ba.
The joy of Nightline.
Ba 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 ba. Ba 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 ba.
The joy of Nightline.
Ba 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 ba.
Come on.
From New York, the greatest city in the world, it's the Late Show with David Letterman.
Slow down.
Good evening.
Let him see the teeth.
I'm Dave. And you know something? You know, ABC really wanted me to do the news. And I'll tell you something. I could have done it, except I couldn't get my hair as thick and as black and as lustrous as Ernie Anastas. Anyway, I really want to keep Nightline on the air. It's a very exciting program. So, here are my top five ways under my new contract. I'm being paid twice as much and I work half as hard. So my top five ways to keep Nightline on the air. Number five, adopt Mayor Bloomberg's popular commuter toll plan and charge people from Jersey $25 to watch. That's number five. Number four is tell Cablevision customers ABC really is the Yes Network in disguise. And number three, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, naked. Now, I knew you'd like number three. Number two, thank you. Number two, hire Lizzie Grubman to do Jay Leno's PR.
And the number one way to keep Nightline on the air, a live broadcast of the Enron trials, convictions, and executions. There you have it.
Yee-haw! That letterman can give me the news any time. Bartender, I need a whiskey, straight, and send the tab to the tab I got here, the Enron 401k plan.
Straight? I thought you Enron guys were on the rocks. Kinda late.
Well, you have.
On the advice of my attorney, I'll take a fifth.
Tweet. I blew the whistle on these Enron desperados, and what did I get for it? Well, okay, a book deal. But Arthur Anderson took me off their dance card at the annual accountant's sock hop.
Tweet.
Lying and denying all day long. And dumping and run. Pigeons are gone, what a dastardly deed. Cause those guys bow to money and greed. Robbing and run.
Tweet.
You're robbing and run, but revenge is oh so sweet. Went before Congress, killing and lay. A couple of crooks had nothing to say. I came along and told the whole tale. Maybe they'll spend hard time in jail. Robbing and
Robbing and Ron.
We're robbing and Ron, but revenge is oh so sweet. Yeah.
Tweet.
Aw, the stockholders aren't all that angry, are they? Let me hear what they have to say.
You bastard!
That was better than eating.
You're welcome. Ma'am, don't blame old Kenny boy. I'm only the CEO. Why, I was so out of it, I thought pump and dump was what Clinton did to Lewinsky. Oh. Groan all you want, but I'd rather be a dumb incompetent than a smart inmate. What a shame that my employees curse my name, say I'm a sleaze. Wasn't me there cooking Enron's books. Don't know much about the cash I took. But I do know if the SEC says they're gonna come and mess with me, it's a wonderful thing to play dumb. Now, I don't claim to be a Rhodes Scholar, but it's plain to see the suckers that trusted me till I got busted won't get a dime from me. Congress blew up when I took the fifth. Phony outrage if you get my drift. Cheney swear on bended knees I didn't influence their policies. But I know that one and one is two. Rich get richer and the poor get screwed. It's a wonderful thing to play dumb. Yuck, yuck, yuck. It's a wonderful thing to play dumb.
Sheriff Bush, we need your help. Enron's not the only problem. The federal treasury is gone.
Well, how'd that happen?
We got ambushed by the Indians at Mohegan Sun. Paul O'Neill put it on bread and spun the big wheel.
Well, how can I help? I don't do domestic.
Hey, I do domestics.
Well, Bill Clinton. The Harlem Globetrotter.
Hey, how's about getting some of your Democrat friends to help promote my economic stimulus package?
Hey, I don't know about the economic part, but if you want a stimulus package, I'm your guy.
Boy, I'll tell you, you got it made. Working on 125th Street, you can buy all the latest DVDs you want for $5. You get a panoramic view of the Major Deegan, and just think all the tomatoes you can squeeze at the fairway.
Shoot, think of the tomatoes I can squeeze right here.
Having a ball up in old Harlem town, strutting my stuff on the street. I give a speech each week and watch my earnings peak. Oh!
Kitchy, kitchy, yeah, 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 yeah. Woo! Kitchy, kitchy, yeah, 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 yeah. Push and shove, yeah, 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 yeah. Woo!
This beats being president.
Cool French words mean, ha, but they could lead to good times. Since the weight of the world has been lifted from me. Oh!
Kitchy, kitchy, yeah, 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 yeah. Woo! Kitchy, kitchy, yeah, 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 yeah. Woo! Oh, that's shelter, yeah, 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 yeah.
This beats being president. Hey. Can I get you girls a drink?
I'll have a tequila mockingbird.
Get me a sex on the beach.
Ooh.
Those voices seem awful familiar. Wait a minute. Jenna! Barbara!
Hi, Dad!
Boy, heck, I can't get mad at you. You remind me of when I was your age. Why, it was only yesterday, maybe 20 years ago.
You know, marrying George Bush was the best thing that ever happened to me. I think one day he'll be president of the Texas Rangers. Well, maybe I'm aiming too high, but at least we have these two beautiful children. You know, I was gonna breastfeed them, but I think they're bottle babies. When you walk into a bar, it makes a difference who you are. Buying drinks with fake ID is so Bush League. I tried to feed you at the breast, but you like the bottle best. Don't bump up to 90 proof. W hit the roof. Sober's great. The press will stay away from girls who knit and pray, so don't get tipsy. Barbara, Jenna, hear my plea. Shame will come to George and me when you walk into a bar. Please,
believe how cute we were back then.
I can't believe how the media left us alone back then. Nowadays, order one watermelon margarita at Senor Swanky's, and we're on the front page of the New York Post.
Order 20 watermelon margaritas, and people think you're Steve Dunleavy.
Dishing our detail, out for a cocktail. Showed our IDs and we're out for the night. Scamming the bouncers, chugging 12 ounces. She's not such a good girl and she's not too bright. Wasted away again in Margaritaville. Trying to stay off another front page. Some people claim that our daddy's to blame, but you know, we're not underage. Drinking a Cosmo, reading a Cosmo. Suddenly several reporters arrive. They want to bust us. What's all the big fuss? W's daughters don't have to drive. Wasted away again in Margaritaville. Hoping the cops don't throw us in jail. Some people claim that our daddy's to blame anyway. He'll put up the veil.
Can you imagine that? Princess Whitewater of Chappaqua. The Bush girls are actually complaining that they're in the news too much.
They'll learn, Chief Slinging Ball Schumer. By the time they're our age, cable television will have 5,000 channels, 4,000 devoted to home shopping. There will be an urgent need for talking heads to fill the airtime. This could be a great national crisis.
I have the solution. The medicine man was just telling me about a new process called cloning, and he gave me this elixir from the Double or Nothing labs. Let's try it.
Look, it's working. I've been cloned.
Actually, I'm Tipper Gore.
And I've been cloned too.
Actually, I'm Al Sharpton.
Close enough. Now, Princess Hillary and I will achieve our greatest ambition to be on every single Sunday morning news show at the same time.
More of me. Why not take more of me? On TV, I'll be on every channel.
Meet the press, face the nation the same time.
Marsha and Gabe, double dipping is no crime.
MTV and MSNBC.
You'll see me no matter what station.
So if you care to see us everywhere, then why not make more of?
Don't make it less of.
Why not make more of? Make more of me.
You know, things were so innocent in those days. Now you gotta be on your toes. Bring me the Director of Homeland Security, Tom Ridge.
The country appears to be safe and sound, Sheriff. Yep. However, we caught him on the sofa near the White House television set. He says his name is Mr. Salty.
Anybody got dip?
You had me there for a minute, Mr. Salty. You know, I almost fell prey to a snack attack.
But Sheriff, I am a soft pretzel.
What goes on behind bedroom doors is your own business.
Ah, come on, Sheriff, I'm not that bad. Let's twist again while we're watching TV. Hey, let's twist again. Snacking time is here. Do you remember when I was your whole diet? Way back in the days when you were drinking beer.
Get that pretzel out of here. The sheriff has more important things to worry about. Like that wily fox, Geraldo Rivera, out in the desert, packing heat.
I'm standing here on historic ground. Right here, on this very spot, exactly 24 hours ago, I made my debut on the Fox News Channel. I mean, right here, on this spot, exact spot, I made my debut. Still not right. Well, close enough for Fox. But that's not why we're here in the desert. We're here in the desert because I, Geraldo, I have found the secret hiding place of a man who has been on the run for weeks. This is a man who stands to lose it all once he is discovered and justice triumphs.
You mean Osama?
Oh, no. I mean Jack Welch. You know, the former chairman of General Electric. The prenup, it's expired. His wife, she's gonna take it all. What in the world was she thinking? Maybe his girlfriend Susie could explain.
At GE, I brought good things to life.
Looks like this one's not gonna last either. Well, isn't there a gal out there who can make this captain of industry happy and restore the sanctity of marriage?
Start spreading the news.
Liza, that was some wedding. Too bad Mayor Bloomberg and Whitney Houston couldn't make it.
But Virginia Fields showed. I tell you, Geraldo, I've got a good feeling about this one. Maybe this time I'll be lucky. Maybe this time he'll stay. Maybe this time I'll stay married, even though he is gay. I'm in love, you see, with publicity. Life in rehab was a bore, so I left for husband number four. So many has-beens came to my wedding, it looked like Hollywood Squares. Mickey Rooney, Cindy Adams, both too old to climb stairs. Well, all you reporters, you think I'm trashy, but the joke's not on me. 'Cause every time you mock my love life, I get a lot of, you give me lots of free publicity.
Man, that was brutal. If America's ever gonna get its spirits back, we need some decent entertainment, some laughs. That's why I'm so proud of these two fellows that we recently found hiding in Momar's comedy cellar. Ladies and gentlemen, straight from the sands, may I give you Saddam Hussein, come on Saddam, and Ali Back Alley.
Asia Minor, Professor. We're the snakes of Araby. Our beg is treachery. Yasar, Osam, and me. We're the unholy three. Bush one, he hit Baghdad. Bush two, he wants me bad. Happy Iraq will be when Saddam is history. Say, don't I know you? I can't remember names, but I never forget a fez. How are things in Tora Bora? Are the 52 still bombing there?
Perhaps we met when I matriculated at Tora Bora CUNY.
Ah, yes, Tora Bora, where our men are lonely and the sheep are nervous.
Not for me. The INS just renewed my student visa. I'm training to be a pastry chef at the New York Hilton. But speaking of sheep, Saddam, how is your lammy pie, Gomorrah?
Hi, yes, Gomorrah. I'm supposed to meet her under the palm tree. She promised me lots of dates.
She used to walk far behind you, Saddam, as is the custom. But now she walks well in front of you. Is that women's lib?
No, landmines.
You know, if that's the best the evil axis has to offer, I'm not worried. In fact, I'm getting to love this job of mine. $10 billion flexing muscles in the Afghan war. I blast blasting Taliban fighters into caves around Kandahar. I ordered laser-guided missiles and bombers by the score. I'm going after people who is rotten to the core. I'm looking for Osama as he wallows in the mud. I'm proving to Laura I'm a genuine stud. I like it, I love it, I want some more of it. I try so hard, I can't rise above it. Don't know what it is about the power of the kill, but I like it, I love it, I want some more of it. In the White House isn't driving me out of my mind. Watching football with a beverage, I was sitting on my lonely behind. I was chomping on a pretzel when I hit the deck. I told the world I choked, but the truth is egg I wrecked. Lori hid the bottles and threw out all the cans, protecting my image like only she can. I like it, I love it, I want some more of it. I try so hard, I can't rise above it. Don't know what it is about puking on my boots, but I like it, I love it, I want some more of it. Now, where's that posse I sent out? I need a report on how the country is doing.
The posse's back, sir. Morale is high. The economy is recovering. And in New York, Mayor Bloomberg is getting to like the town so much, he decided to stay the weekend.
And it looks like we're going to be all right.
Come on along and listen to the heartbeat of the city.
New York is standing strong and tall. We're tough and strong and gritty.
The rattle of the taxi cabs, the rumble of a subway, or watching all the neighbors grab the daily news on Sunday.
For two centuries we've been on top, America's best city. We'll never sleep, we'll never stop. We're stronger now. Dawn breaks, sunlight, nights past. We will not forget. New York loves you. Sleep tight, we'll be seeing you someday.
Listen to the heartbeat of a brave New York.
Come on along and listen to the heartbeat of a country. We love the great red, white, and blue, the good old USA. The world in wonder watches us, from Farmer Joe to Wall Street. We're arm in arm and hand in hand. Dawn breaks, sunlight, night's past. We will not forget. The world loves you. Sleep tight, we'll be seeing you someday. Destroys the darkness. Into the future we all go. Hope grants our hearts. Listen to the heartbeat of
I want to thank all of you for coming to the 2002 edition of the Inner Circle Show. As you can imagine, this is a labor of love in which political reporters get the chance to sing some of the things we would like to write but just wouldn't get away with in our day jobs. It was November when the writing committee began to mull over the prospects for this year's show. And it only took us 5 months to write this year's production. Amazing, right? This is a show that would not have been without the man who chairs our writing committee, Larry Sutton of People Magazine. Sweet tone, come up front. This man is the heart and soul, the brick and mortar of this organization, and a man of great wit and even greater patience. Now, every Inner Circle president needs an executive assistant to the president. Mark Lieberman, formerly a reporter for the Daily News, and now a senior vice president and economist with Washington Mutual, formerly the Dime Savings Bank. Mark began keeping me out of trouble last summer when we started meetings with the Hilton Hotel and others who have to be contracted and paid so this show can go on. By the way, Mark Lieberman. Over the past dozen years, the Inner Circle has given over 200 primarily local charities over $1 million from the proceeds of the generous folks who attend our Saturday night festivities. So a big thank you for being here tonight. I would like to thank the man in tails, whose tail has been turned to the audience all night as he does his best to keep those of us up here on stage in line, on cue, our director of 20 years, former AP reporter, now resuming his career as a government and public relations consultant, Paul Buer. Of course, getting this group of dedicatedly non-professional performers to entertain musically has been the annual challenge, well met by the Inner Circle music director, Kathy Beaver. Every year on the Monday rehearsal of show week, this week, last Monday, the cast members are saying, sometimes screaming, there's no way we're getting this show over the tree line this year. Somehow Kathy pilots us up, up and away. Our choreographer, Sari Allen Brewer, had the formidable task of getting this group of part-time thespians to sing and dance at the same time. No mean feat for a choreographer working with so many performers with two left feet. Now, all through the rehearsal season months down at City Hall, the City Council chamber piano has been the only source of accompaniment. And the man whose talents help shape our songs is our pianist and assistant musical director, Steven Silverstein. Who will be at the piano in the West Penthouse after the show so you can sing along to the mayor's songs or ours. Take your choice. Steven will be there. And of course, the first victims from outside of our little group here to see the playlet and hear the songs are our band members. Now, when they show up on Wednesday of show week, we watch for their reactions as the first test of our material. If the band laughs, that line or song stays in or gets stretched. The band. Take a bow. Yeah. Now, from Cashman to Mr. Salty to the Burka Babes, tonight's wonderful costumes are the creations of our Inner Circle costumer, Catherine Piper, and her helpers, Catherine Piper, all right. Especially Deirdre Kirk. Where's Deirdre Kirk? Deirdre has been at so many of our rehearsals fitting and measuring. Never have so few stitched so much for so many. Catherine's mom and sister even came down from New Hampshire to help. So thanks for your imaginative efforts. And thanks, too, for the many hard working hours that have been put in by our Inner Circle costume coordinator, Lisa Colangelo of the Daily News City Hall Bureau. And don't forget, the best of our costume team's handiwork is still up for silent auction in the ballroom lobby. I want to thank Tom Kelly. He's the press secretary of the Metropolitan Transportation Authority and a former AP reporter. He handles security, dress rehearsal night, ticketing, and an occasional hilarious role up here on stage. Now, Dan Andrews, otherwise known as Mr. Salty, formerly of UPI, now spokesman for Queensboro President Helen Marshall, was in charge of the show programs. We want to thank also, speaking of the programs, the creative minds and hands of Randy and Suzanne Jones for their original program, at their artwork, their set backdrops. The original artworks are also part of the silent auction. So the fact that you heard us so well, saw our video, our backdrop projections, is due to the work of Glenn Davis of GSD Productions. Thanks to all and their crew. I want to thank my predecessor, now Inner Circle Board Chairman, David Seifman, the New York Post City Hall Bureau Chief. David is a big idea fountain in the writing committee, and he manages to handle numerous crises that pop up on the business end of producing the show. Now, my successors, this year's Vice President, next year's Inner Circle President, Sheila Steinbeck of Court TV. Yeah. Treasurer Richard Steyer of the Chief Newspaper. Richard! I think watching Richie Steyer do the side dancing to that Latino number was worth the price of admission myself, personally. That was my personal. And Secretary Jim Harney of the Daily News. Now, if you might have noticed, we had a considerable age range among our actors tonight. Polly Kreisman and Josh Dionne's 12-week-old twins, Molly and Jack, were the Baby Bush girls. Yeah. All right, here they are. Which one's Jack? Jack. Jack, following an old Inner Circle tradition, had to play Baby Jenna Bush in drag. And until now, 91 years young, Edith Evans Asbury of the New York Times broke the Inner Circle sex barrier in 1972. Prior to Edie getting her way into this organization, all the women's roles had been played by men in drag. I think we can all salute Edie's pioneering ways and what it has brought us today.
Yes, it is.
We also want to salute our members who are celebrating 50 years or more as Inner Circle members. The Dean of the Inner Circle is former New York Postie Edward Ketcher, who joined the Inner Circle in 1948 and is a past president. There he is, all right. Gabe Pressman celebrated his 50th Inner Circle anniversary last year. Our other golden members are Artie Masolo, formerly of the New York Post. Harold Harris of the Brooklyn Eagle and Journal American. And Marvin Sleeper of the Journal American. Now sadly, we lost four Inner Circle members this past year. Jack Shanahan, the former City Hall Bureau Chief for the AP. Jack attended our first rehearsal down at City Hall this year, and we were all shocked and saddened to learn that Jack died at home that same night. Our condolences to Jack's family, many of whom are here tonight enjoying the show. Welcome to the Shanahans. Always a part of the Inner Circle. You get the feeling that Jack's here somewhere. I don't know. Maureen O'Neill had been the 30-year member of the Inner Circle and a reporter for Newsday for more than three decades. Maureen passed away just a few days after Jack. Last year, we lost another beloved Inner Circle member, Glenn Fowler, formerly of the New York Times. And finally, Bob Williams, who covered politics for the New York Post before moving on to become a Post TV critic, also passed away since we got together the last time. They will all be badly missed. That is our show for this year, and one final Inner Circle tradition, our oldest and newest members, Ed Catcher and Ty Hernandez of ABC News, will now escort Mayor Bloomberg to the stage. All right, are they off to get the mayor?
After a brief intermission.
All right,
after a brief intermission,
Mayor Mike and company are gonna get their licks in at us, the media. You have been a great audience. I hope you all have nothing worth satirizing coming up in your years. We will see you next spring. Mayor Mike, it's next.
Thank you.
Let's get a little spotlight down to Mayor Mike's table here so we can see him coming up, and Ed and Ty. Right over here is the mayor.
Whoa. Step out.
All right. Hi, Mayor. Hey, Mayor.
Mayor is coming.
We still got a lot of new directors on stage, huh?
Mayor is coming.
Mayor Mike, I hope we didn't gore you in any way that's irreplaceable. I hope you're looking forward to giving us a great show, and I hope you'll be here every year.
Well, thank you. One of the advantages of going last is that you get a chance to respond. And for those of you who don't understand either what you just saw or what you're about to see, I would suggest that the City Hall Bureau, formerly Room 9 at City Hall, now in the new press office on the southern tip of Staten Island in Tottenville, be happy to explain it to you. We'll be back, folks. Thank you.
And Secretary Jim Harney of the Daily News. Now, if you might have noticed, we had a considerable age range among our actors tonight. Polly Kreisman and Josh Dionne's 12-week-old twins, Molly and Jack, were the baby Bush girls. All right, here they are. Which one's Jack? Jack, following an old Inner Circle tradition, had to play baby Jenna Bush in drag. And until now, 91 years young, Edith Evans Asbury of the New York Times broke the Inner Circle sex barrier in 1972. Prior to Edie getting her way into this organization, all the women's roles had been played by men in drag. I think we can all salute Edie's pioneering ways and what it has brought us today.
Yes, it is.
We also want to salute our members who are celebrating 50 years or more as Inner Circle members. The Dean of the Inner Circle is former New York Postie Edward Catcher, who joined the Inner Circle in 1948 and is a past president. There he is, all right. Gabe Pressman celebrated his 50th Inner Circle anniversary last year. Our other golden members are Artie Masolo, formerly of the New York Post. Harold Harris of the Brooklyn Eagle and Journal American. And Marvin Sleeper of the Journal American. Now sadly, we lost four Inner Circle members this past year. Jack Shanahan, the former City Hall Bureau Chief for the AP. Jack attended our first rehearsal down at City Hall this year, and we were all shocked and saddened to learn that Jack died at home that same night. Our condolences to Jack's family, many of whom are here tonight enjoying the show. Welcome to the Shanahans, always a part of the Inner Circle. You get the feeling that Jack's here somewhere. I don't know. Maureen O'Neill had been the 30-year member of the Inner Circle and a reporter for Newsday for more than three decades. Maureen passed away just a few days after Jack. Last year, we lost another beloved Inner Circle member, Glenn Fowler, formerly of the New York Times. And finally, Bob Williams, who covered politics for the New York Post before moving on to become a Post TV critic, also passed away since we got together the last time. They will all be badly missed. That is our show for this year, and one final Inner Circle tradition, our oldest and newest members, Ed Catcher and Ty Hernandez of ABC News, will now escort Mayor Bloomberg to the stage. All right, are they off to get the mayor?
After a brief intermission.
All right.
After a brief intermission,
Mayor Mike and company are gonna get their licks in at us, the media. You have been a great audience. I hope you all have nothing worth satirizing coming up in your years. We will see you next spring. Mayor Mike, it's next.
Thank you.
Let's get a little spotlight down to Mayor Mike's table here so we can see him coming up, and Ed and Ty. Right over here is the mayor.
Step out.
Hi, Mayor. Hi, Mayor. Hey,
Mayor is coming.
We still got a lot of new directors on stage, huh?
Mayor Mike, I hope we didn't gore you in any way that's irreplaceable. I hope you're looking forward to giving us a great show, and I hope you'll be here every year.
Well, thank you. One of the advantages of going last is that you get a chance to respond. And for those of you who don't understand either what you just saw or what you're about to see, I would suggest that the City Hall Bureau, formerly Room 9 at City Hall, now in the new press office on the southern tip of Staten Island in Tottenville, be happy to explain it to you. We'll be back, folks. Thank you.